What's up? Dr. Swole here with our third video in the series, Basics of Training, where I teach you about the basic concepts of building a training program and walk you through step-by-step how to create your own workout plan. In this episode, we'll be talking about training volume. Now, at this point in the literature, volume is probably the training variable that is best correlated with hypertrophy. Scientific researchers typically define volume as number of sets times number of reps times the weight. It is basically the amount of work that you are accumulating for a certain muscle group. For our purposes, we will be defining volume as the number of hard sets. It's been shown that once you get over a certain threshold of training intensity, it doesn't really matter how many reps you actually do. It's really the number of hard sets that matter. So what defines a hard set? Generally, we say that a hard set is defined as a set that you take to within 4 reps of failure. Let's say on an all-out squat attempt, you take 100 pounds and you squat 10 reps. On the 11th rep, going up, you actually fail halfway and can't finish the rep. A hard set would then be defined as 6 reps at 100 pounds. That's within 4 reps of failing. Now, the most important thing about training volume that I want to stress in this video is that training volume is very individual. You need to figure out your own optimal training volume for your program. And this is where preset training programs fail. If you go online, find a program from some fitness guru and copy their workout word for word, you're copying their training volume, and it's probably not optimal for you. I would say that this is even where science has its limitations, because in the studies that have been put out so far, we haven't really found an actual upper limit to the amount of training volume that you can do. That being said, in practical terms, there obviously is a limit to how much volume you can carry out in your own program. The amount of training volume that is optimal for you probably depends on your genetic responsiveness to training volume, how hard you train, and your ability to recover. The bottom line is that you should choose a training volume that allows you to progress optimally. Here I'd like to introduce the volume landmarks, as introduced by Dr. Mike Isertel. This is a graph that relates the amount of gains you get per training volume. On the y-axis, we have your rate of gains, which I describe as the amount of gains you're getting per week. And on the x-axis, we have volume, which we have defined as the number of hard sets per week. Now, the volume landmarks describe a few points on this curve that are of interest to us. Note that our rate of gains has a positive and a negative side on this graph, which means obviously you can be making progress, but you can also be losing progress. And it makes sense that if you do a small enough amount of volume, you're going to lose your muscle. Now, the first volume landmark that I'm going to introduce is called maintenance volume. And this we'll put on the graph as MV. And that is the point on the graph where you're doing enough volume to just maintain your muscle. You're not gaining, you're not losing. Your rate of progress is zero. The next concept that I'll introduce is called minimum effective volume, which is described on this graph by this initial red part. Basically, the minimum effective volume is the minimum amount of volume that you can do and still grow. Essentially, what that means is on this graph, as soon as you break into the positives, you're at your minimum effective volume. After MEV, we have maximum adaptive volume. And that is the amount of volume that allows you to progress at your maximum rate, which we'll put here at this maximum point, MAV. I'll note that the MAV is difficult to pin down since it can change week to week. But obviously, this is what we're targeting. The last volume landmark is called MRV, or maximum recoverable volume. And this is the maximum amount of volume that you can still do and recover. I'll put this on the graph as MRV. You can see that when you go beyond your MRV, your progress actually dips into the negative. Simply put, if you go beyond your MRV, you're not recovering enough to actually progress. Now, in my first video, I made a recommendation of about 10 to 20 sets per body part per week. Now that we have these concepts in mind, I'll say that that 10 is around minimum effective volume, and the 20 sets is around maximum recoverable volume. So for a beginner, I'd probably recommend starting at about 10 sets per muscle group per week. So for quads, that might work out to doing 3 sets of squats 3 times per week. Now recall that training volume is the third step in our staircase of training priorities. Sustainability is the first step, and it ultimately dictates how much volume you can do. If you have a lot of time and you're serious about training, you might want to try doing more volume. On the other hand, if you're really busy and tight on time, you might want to shoot for less volume, maybe something closer to minimum effective volume. Now for our staircase of training priorities, note that progressive overload also ranks higher than volume. What that means is we should be setting our training volume in a way that allows us to maximize progressive overload. So now that I've told you that training volume is very individual, how do you go about finding what volume works best for you? I've put together a graph of these volume landmarks as we discussed in a chart format that Dr. Mike Isertel described himself. These are the approximate numbers at these volume landmarks that most people respond to. Note that it actually depends on which muscle group you're looking at. In short, I would suggest starting somewhere in the MEV numbers and then adding sets as you're able to. If you continue adding sets and find that you stop progressing, you've probably hit your maximum recoverable volume. Now, in terms of troubleshooting, if you find that you're not progressing week to week, you should consider adding or subtracting sets to your workouts to allow you to progress. If you do too little volume, your progress will be in the negative since you're not providing enough stimulus to the muscle to grow. Conversely, when you get to too much volume and surpass MRV, your body's not going to be able to recover from that volume and you will stop progressing as well. The last thing that I'll mention is that the body becomes resistant to volume over time. What that means is that we're going to have to take deloads or low volume phases that will allow our muscles to resensitize to volume and for further growth. That's all for now, guys. Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe, like the video, comment below, and make sure you let me know what questions you want to see answered. See you next time.